2022, as Commissioner for ESD2, and then agenda item number 7, the Fairfield Director of County Government, discussing take action on appointment of Lynn Cunningham as Commissioner of ESD2.
Judge, I interview both of these gentlemen. They are extremely qualified and are going to be a very nice addition, in my opinion. So I make a motion that we accept our approval.
Motion by Commissioner Wiley, second by Commissioner Height. I guess it was the closest one. So it was a tie. So is there any more discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay, motion carries.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Welcome aboard.
Did you hear Lynn Cunningham?
Yes.
Do you have?
I know Lynn Cunningham's attorney, so I'll let him talk to you.
Oh. Yeah, we will just send him middle of the week.
Okay. If y'all would, I'll swear you have not now, while everybody is here. Raise your right hand. Okay, in the name of the by the authority of the state of Texas, official office. Aye, picture name one.
Lynn Cunningham, please.
Okay, do solemnly swear or affirm.
Do solemnly swear or affirm.
That I will faithfully execute the duties.
That I will faithfully execute the duties.
Of the office of Commissioner ESD number 2.
Of the office of Commissioner ESD number 2.
Of the state of Texas.
Of the state of Texas.
And will to the best of my ability.
And will to the best of my ability.
Preserve, protect, and defend.
Preserve, protect, and defend.
The Constitution and laws.
The Constitution and laws.
Of the United States.
Of the United States.
And of this state.
And of this state.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Thank you. Congratulations. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
If y'all would, this is you. And this is your, this is on the back, and this is a sign. Thank you. Of course, we'll get them back to the meeting. We'll get them signed. If you want copies, say well.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, we're moving on to agenda item number 8, which addresses the county judge, Nikki Storer, Wilson County Library, discussing take action on submitting grant paperwork to the Foundation for $33,744 to replace shelving and lounge furniture for the Sarah Bain Chandler Public Library in Stockdale. Okay, Nikki is not here for this one. She was looking away for it. She got back and put it on, but I said, I'm going to go ahead and take care of it for you. This is a grant that she has got that was for furniture for the new library. This is furniture for the library. It's kind of it's hard to believe. They'll give her the money. There's no
strings.
No, nothing. Here's the money and use it for furniture. There's no matching. There's no guarantees. Nothing. It's really a good grant.
It's through a foundation, that's what.
Yeah.
Through a little foundation. There's no match.
Yeah. They don't check. I mean, they said here's the money. Go buy your furniture. Discussion. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion carries.
Okay.
They've already got approved by the bond, the purchases, and the set rate, so I really don't see any problem with this. I'll make a motion that we approve the variance.
Motion by Commissioner Fall, second by Commissioner Hyatt, is there any more discussion, everything is in order?
Yes.
We have any fight to have over there?
I'm not even out of order here.
Any issues?
Not that we can tell.
Okay. Is there any more discussion?
All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, we're going to the agenda, item number ten, Curtis Skip Hyatt, Commissioner precinct three, discuss take action on purchase, purchasing from buy order and dump truck from Peterbilt for precinct three. I'll make a motion to approve the move. Motion by Hyatt, sir.
I'll say it.
Second by Commissioner Gomez, is there any more discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? On the agenda, item number eleven. Our Congress, eleven A, discuss and take action, refer to the hauling and disposal contract for the county collection facility.
Okay, on this one, I know the last commission's report, we set a date of a go off of this on the, for the hauling and disposal of that, for the collection facility. But on that contract that we have, for that bidding, not the bidding, the contract for the disposal, there's a paragraph that says how this will be awarded, and I'm going to read it out on that contract. It says the contract period. This contract is the period for December 15, 2016 through December 14, 2017. Furthermore, if either party does not give within notice within 60 days of this anniversary, this contract will renew as a new 1-year term extension. So I think the way it says there for that contract, it automatically renews right now for that facility, so.
And I assume it's going to keep it at the same price.
At the same price, right.
So the only question I would have is that at the meeting we had, and the council wasn't there, and I'm assuming there's no problem with our renewing.
Oh, we're assuming that.
Okay.
Well, the only thing is if we want to go back and award it to the same company, if we want to change the contract, instead of saying that 60 days, we have 30 days. It's up to the court to decide that. Instead of saying 60 days, we'll put it as 30 days.
Okay, now here's the deal according to the contract, okay? It renews, we didn't give 60 days those, plus there is another clause in here, and if it, we have to give, terminate, we have to give 60 days. Cancellation of contract, either party may terminate this contract within 60 days. Okay, here's what we probably need to do, is go ahead and let it renew itself, and then give 60 days notice, and we're going to terminate and go out for bids where we can keep ourselves with the competitive bidding statute, keep ourselves in line with that. That's my deal. I mean, I'm sure they're going to get it again because they beat everybody else pretty bad last time. But just to keep ourselves within that statute on competitive bidding. Yes?
No, I didn't have anything to say.
Oh, okay. That's my deal. I mean, if for 3 days it's going to renew automatically, then we need to send a notice that in 60 days, and the bids have been going out for now. Now, how do we, because they haven't been advertised.
No, they haven't been advertised.
Okay, then we can, then we'll need to go out for bids again after this 60-day period. I guess we can do it now, that way when the 60-day period's up.
Well, I didn't write the contract, it came as a passage to get tackled, and I think it's internally inconsistent.
What's that?
It's internally inconsistent.
Oh.
On the front page, it says this is a one-year contract, all the way through it says it's a one-year contract, and then that one provision just happens.
To be there.
Well, to say, you know, we can cancel it on 60 days' notice or remove.
Basically, when that paragraph means if we don't give them a 60-day notice, then it automatically renews, correct?
Yes, but I'm saying that contradicts other parts of it.
Right, it says it's a one-year contract. But is that still binding?
Well, what about the other parts of the contract? I mean, on the first page, it says this is a one-year contract.
It's a one-year contract.
It's kind of picking and choosing which provision you're saying is going to control.
I'm not, you know, it contradicts itself, whatever. I think, you know, if we need to cover our tracks for the 60 days term, notice, or it's going to expire anyway this month and go out to bid. I mean, my deal is just to stay up with the competitive bidding statute. You know, if we do let it, we need to send a notice and go out to bid.
So we're going to extend it for 60 days, right?
I'm sorry?
We're going to extend it for 60 days.
Well, it's not going to be extended, it's just going to automatically renew. But then we're going to send, this is what we need to do, we need to send a notice that in 60 days it terminates, and then that's the date that we need to put on our bids for the next one.
Come in.
Has the price gone to $50,000 for the bid?
Yes.
But I mean.
What's that, what are the pros and cons? What's the downside bid? Just going to take them time to put a bid together?
I guess we want to make certain that we have continual service.
Service?
Yes.
Is that a big question?
I mean, what worries me more than anything, we had one bidder last year, and if something happens that they don't rebid, then we're out of service. And I don't know how we want to let them fall off. I mean, it could. Nothing says they have to bid. If we try to buck the contract or whatever the wording is,
it's not bucking the contract, it's staying with the contract.
I know, I'm saying, but if we don't go forward with what the contract says.
Well, that's what we're going to do. It's going to, in 3 days, it's going to automatically
be renewed.
Be renewed. Then we send a notice that we're going to be bidding on the contract, and to stay up with the competitive bid statutes, we need to rebid. That's just because it's mandated we're supposed to do that. It's only $50,000.
Are they unhappy with it? I mean, you're saying they're not going to bid again if they have to bid up?
No, just in case.
Just in case.
Just in case they don't bid.
They're happy and we're happy with the service. I mean, we call, they're there within the next day to pick up the roll off, pick up whatever they got to do. Even on weekends, they come and pick it up.
Well, I think the phone call would be in order to them, letting them know that statutory would require to go out for bid because of the amount. That way, this is their service. It's completely their service, we have to do that.
Now, if they're through the buy board, do we still have to go out? There is a buy board system.
Is that, but that's not how we got
it? No.
There is a buy board, how would that?
I mean, I don't know all the details, but they're in the buy board.
If we get the services through buy board, we would not have to go out for bids.
Okay, let me ask you this, what are their prices through the buy board?
I have no idea.
Are they comparable to what they get?
I know Tom Ball just looked it up the other day, and they're in the buy board, but I don't know what they offer, what they do, you know, for it. They didn't really specifically say a contract or say it was in the buy board.
I know they didn't buy board. This is the first I've heard about Ball, I didn't mention that. Mm-hmm.
We looked it up.
Okay.
Right, they're in the buy board.
I would think that we need to communicate to them then that we want to bid through the buy board, and then we can bypass all of this in the future.
So that,
if that price of the buy board is compared to the one we've got here.
Yes, that's true. Well, I guess it would.
Might could be, yeah, less.
Harvesting.
The only bad news is you've got a price increase.
Yeah.
Because normally everyone
So will everyone know this? That will.
Let's get to the bill of the Bible. That's kind of got my curiosity about there.
We need to rescind that property.
Yes.
Our motion from the last meeting, and it all likely gets go for renewal, and we have to send them the 60 days, when it's 60 days prior to that.
Well, what we do, if we go with the contract next time, is be sure that clause is out there, and it terminates, and be sure we don't wait till the last minute.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying, we can terminate that, what is it, the 60 days?
After we give them the notice.
After we give them that notice. We'll give them the 60-day notice, so that way, in 60 days, we're gonna go up with it.
To me, that would seem to make them more upset, rather than less.
Well, yeah, I think that.
Because then we're terminating, you know, terminating the agreement.
Yeah, but I said that we need to communicate with them, and let them know that this is what we're having to do because of statutory requirements.
I don't know that we're pleading with the service.
Yeah.
But we're required by law to have to go out for a bid or look at the Bible.
Let me ask a question by law. The statute says anything over $50,000, but does that overrule a contract?
Yes.
It does?
Oh, yes.
You can't write a contract in.
There's no doubt to me, looking at this, that that was just a mistake in the original agreement. Because it doesn't match up with all the other things in the agreement. I mean, that's my opinion, I didn't write it. If you look just at the, you know, on the front page, it says this is a one-year agreement.
And no one else said that's true?
No.
Well, no one else said that before, so I think
we communicate to them.
So I don't know, but I have to work the service.
Yeah.
It's just hard to drive to do.
And basically, one of the biggest, I guess I know why you have to do it, is they own the landfill out there, so they can give us another rate. Where if another company was to bid it, they'll have to pay our disposal fee. You know, they're working that into their contract work.
Right.
So what we want, I'm just making notes on the subway here, is one, we're pleased with their performance. Two, statutory requirements, unfortunately, mean that we have to have this thing rebid. And so to do that, we have to terminate, I guess, or give notice that we're going to terminate the contract. And then
Well, normally you wouldn't, I'm sorry to interrupt, but you, okay. It would automatically.
Renew.
No, it would automatically terminate.
At the end of the period.
Yes. If that provision is.
But at any rate, we need a new bid.
Yes.
We need a new bid. And since they're on the Bible, we want the new bid to be through the Bible.
Well, we got to be sure that everything is right, and we may get a better bid.
Whoever's selling this, we have to communicate. Typically, we get better prices through the Bible. But at the same time, I don't want to lose their business,
yeah.
or lose them as our service. They have been consistent, and that is somewhat of a problem within that industry.
Right.
And for instance, another part says contractor guarantees the rates for 1 year, starting December 15, 2016, and ending December 14, 2017. Contractor may adjust the charges anytime after 30 days written notice to the county on the basis of unusual charges and the cost of operations. Has that been?
No.
So they're saying that for the second year, they would leave it at the same.
Same thing.
It seems to be what they're saying. This is the point. I assume we haven't had communications with them.
Well,
okay, here's the next question is, could we have gone out for a 2-year bid to get with her since it's covered by statute, we have to bid it yearly?
Yeah.
So we need to get the Bible. It's a whole lot easier next year.
can we look at automatically renew, if that's totally what we have to do?
I think we have to go out for bid.
We can't let it automatically renew and then send them, to be sure whether we have coverage, because the coverage is gonna end.
Well, but you all voted last time. I mean, y'all voted last time to go out for bids. If we had gone out for bids 2 weeks ago, we wouldn't have a lapse, would we?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, because we're not, we're working on the bid till the 27th.
Okay, well.
So it's more time on our part.
Yes. I mean, somebody, and I don't wanna point fingers, but somebody from the county, I mean, it's not the job of the commissioner to sit and look at every contract we have and when they're gonna expire or whatever, but.
It's also not the job of the county.
I'm not saying, I'm just saying, maybe it's something we need to look at, having somebody do that, you know, to look at these contracts.
Actually, you know, I propose a contract management, I mean, that's what it's called, contract management, that someone needs to be doing that.
But so we can give it to the commission. Yeah, it should have been done 60 days ago, or letting them know when they're going out for bids, not now.
But, and I, like I said, if it's on the buy board, we can, I don't know, we can renew through the buy board or just go through the buy board.
No, if you're on buy board, you need to go through the buy board, just do a new contract.
New contract.
Just do a buy board.
Yes.
And the other thing would just be to sit down with them, and if they're complaining about that, that it's supposed to be a two-year agreement, I really think we tell them that it's just a fair out in the contract. It was supposed to be a one-year contract, because it was over $50,000.
Well, we didn't know at the time what the total cost was gonna be, and there's no dollar amount in the contract other than what the hauling fee is. You know, it doesn't say $50,000 or $51,000, you know, a dollar amount.
So when we did it before, we didn't know it was gonna be over?
No.
No.
We were pretty sure because of what the previous contractor or whatever you wanna call Lone Star.
We thought it probably was.
We were pretty sure it was gonna be around the $80,000 mark, because that's what they were paying a year.
So let me see if I get this right. If we go to them and say, we want a bid from you through the buy board, if they will do that, and they give us a bid through the buy board, then we can approve that. Right here, we don't really have to go out for a bid. So that's the first thing we have to find out, because otherwise, if we don't go through the buy board, then we have to post it in the paper and give everybody. And it's gonna be interesting getting that done before the end of the month.
Something won't happen.
I didn't think of it. And so the whole key is for whoever's been the contact person, to tell them we need a buy board.
Package.
Package. And if they can get that to us, then we can approve that on the 27th.
Yes.
Does the company perform other services besides the one that we're contracting for? Okay, well, that's what you need to check with buy board. They could be on buy board.
For something else.
Or some other service. And not that service.
Okay. If not, it's gonna automatically.
Couldn't you just sit down and talk to people and say that, you know, there's a contradiction in the contract, but we need to bid it, it's over $50,000? Surely I would think there'd be a way to work that out.
You'll call Terry, you're gonna make a call. Who's that? Got that one. Is that a boss?
Who's that?
The lady from, the public.
Just let this go, and if you say go for 60 days, give them the notice.
Yeah.
They think it's gonna renew automatically.
supposed to end on December 14th. But then perhaps say, can we buy your services for 1 month while we go out for bids? I mean, the going out for bids isn't just something we want to do. It really is a state law.
Well, the key is to find out about the buyer.
And the thing is, you can, I mean, meeting with them, you can amend this contract any way you want to, as long as we both agree.
So we basically can't honor the renewal notice in this contract. We can't let it go ahead automatically, right?
Correct. But let's just say it shows that on the very front, it says this contract is for 1 year, December 14th, 2017. We could sit down with them and say, let's just continue this contract for 1 month, and that will allow us to go out for bids, but would keep us from being without services.
Is 1 month going to be?
That's going to be 1 month.
Well, 2 months.
Not just go out for bid. We're going to need to be 60 days.
Yeah.
Okay. And here's the deal. If it automatically renews and we do the 60 days, we're staying with the contract, what it says.
She said we can't let it automatically renew.
We can't let it automatically renew?
No, I don't think so. Because if you let it automatically renew, then you're not bidding.
I mean, this is just automatic to keep us with the service. That's my
point. Well, I think you could agree with them to let it automatically, I mean, I don't know why you have to automatically renew, but I think you could agree with them for them to work 2 more months while we get the bid package. Just ask them if we can amend this agreement to add that it's going to end February 14th, and then we will have a bid package before then. And we're only off 2 days at Christmas. It's not like everything closes down.
Well, first of all, we have to see if they qualify for this service.
Yes.
That was a multiple problem. So.
Yeah, for this service.
So the new contract would begin February the 14th, if we have...
I mean, you would just have to reach agreement with them, give us time, and they wouldn't have to stop providing the services, and we wouldn't be caught in the works with no one at all. Just trying to make a contract that has contradictory terms work for a couple of months.
So how do we want to word it?
And how you going to get a contract? You know, to get a contract to them, it'd be agreeable to sign.
All you're going to do is say, instead of ending December 14th, 2007, they agree they'll end in February 14th.
We have an extension of this contract, so we get a 60-day extension, essentially.
Right.
Which would take...
And which, again, I mean, it's not... The necessarily the preferable way to do it, but when you've got an internally inconsistent document, you have to find some way to keep us from not having services. Almost like if you're leasing an apartment and you come to the end of your lease and you don't have any place to move, they let you go on a month to month. I mean, to me, it shows our intent not to violate the bidding